The year has flown by, and we are excited to share what's included in the 2023.2 Jenzabar 1 release. Check out these new features and year-end updates. The 2023.2 J1 web release provides updated hub navigation. From the left menu, use the new collapsible drop-down options to access hub pages for each product. The summary option opens the main hub page with info blocks for quick reference. Most summary pages have a block settings button that lets you add and manage block content. Custom blocks let you add information to summary pages for quick reference. Charts, custom content, or data set list options let you display what's important to you. And you can arrange blocks on the page with the Manage Blocks option. The 1099 and 1098T forms don't have any form or media changes this year. We've updated the copy a image file for all forms to use the required red image. Finance features are now generally available in Jenzabar 1 Web. With the new J1 Web Finance license, you can complete daily tasks from the new module hubs. New roles and permissions control access to finance hubs and features. Users must be in the proper roles with permission to work with finance information. In the General Ledger Accounting Hub, you can create and manage GL accounts, enter and post batches, create and monitor projects, and generate reports. From the Asset Management Hub, you can inventory, create, and track capital assets. From the Budget Management Hub, you can create, review, and monitor budgets. Use roles and permissions to manage who can access budget information. You can also view and update departmental budget worksheets and make modifications or transfers to budgets. In the Receivables Management Hub, you can view and update student account information. There are various options available to manage account details for one or more students. You can also view, create, and manage receipts and generate receipt reports. Process student deposits. Generate charges for students. Create student refund invoices. And generate and publish account statements. The Procurement Hub includes both accounts payable and purchasing features. You can create and manage vendors, vendor invoices, and payments. On the purchasing side, you can create and manage requisitions, view, create, and unencumber purchase orders, and receive goods. Stay tuned. We've got more finance features coming soon. Federal tax tables have not been updated yet. When the final version of Publication 15 is released, you can make updates with the script posted to myjenzabar.net or with future DSU/DDU updates. The 2023 tax year is available on the Generate W-2s and Generate 1095Cs windows. Processes have been updated to reflect any government changes for this year. With new social security number masking on W-2s, only the last four digits of the employee's social security number are displayed on the W-2 form. The new tax rate level drop-down on the tax tables window control tab provides options for calculating the NDSIT tax code. Select an option based on the employee's W-4 date. In J1 Web Employee, you can now access the 2023 W-2 and 1095C statements and instructions from a single link on the Annual Statements page. Waitlist Usher is now available in J1 Web. Waitlist Usher sends students an automatic notification when a seat opens so they can move their waitlisted course to the current enrollment status. Settings to enable the feature are on the Enrollment Settings page in the Registration Administration Hub. In J1 Web, Waitlist Usher is an integrated feature that doesn't require managed services for install or maintenance. To use J1 Web Waitlist Usher, you'll need to uninstall the Desktop Waitlist Usher feature to avoid conflicts. For more details, see the release documentation on myjenzabar.net. These are just a few of the great features now available in Jenzabar 1 2023.2. Be sure to read the release news for all the details on what's new.